The Big Book of Angel Tarot, The Essential Guide to Symbols, Spreads, and Accurate Readings by Radleigh Valentine. This audiobook includes a supplemental PDF that contains tarot card spreads, illustrations of the cards, and the About the Artist and About the Author sections from the print edition. To my beloved angel and tarot card community. Introduction. The Creation of Angel Tarot. For decades, I have been fascinated with tarot. Long before I left my career in accounting to pursue a life as a spiritual teacher, I'd been using this ancient divinatory tool to get accurate and reliable answers for friends and clients. While to some, tarot and angels might have seemed like an odd combination, to me they went together like bread and butter. My first angel teacher, Carla, also loved tarot, so it felt completely natural to blend communication with angels and the wisdom of tarot to provide healing and insight to others. While I loved tarot, I was also uncomfortable with the traditional imagery. I was on a never-ending quest for a set of cards that would match my vision of tarot as a compassionate and gentle way to communicate with the divine. Sadly, this search only wound up filling my office with dozens of unused tarot decks. Many had varying positive aspects, but they also seemed to have distressing properties that made me set the decks aside. I found myself in readings with clients trying to minimize their ability to see the most challenging cards by keeping them turned toward myself or by rushing on to the next card in a spread. This was unfortunate, because even the distressing cards in tarot have importance, so trying to ignore them was like ripping a chapter out of a book. Then, magic happened. I had the opportunity to work with Hay House and my mentor to create my dream tarot deck. This became my first deck of Angel Tarot, aptly named Angel Tarot Cards. But it wouldn't be my last. I've been blessed to create multiple decks of Angel Tarot and Oracle cards in the years since. From the beginning, it was very important to me that the cards in my Angel Tarot decks not be some watered-down version of tarot. There's great depth and breadth in the human experience, and I wanted this concept to be fully represented in the cards. When I create a deck, I review all of the symbolism very carefully. When something distressing is removed from an image, I am diligent about replacing it with something peaceful that signifies the same thing. Card names are changed when necessary to more accurately convey the loving message embedded in even the most challenging cards. Historically, tarot has been veiled in an air of mystery, but I don't understand what purpose there could possibly be in making messages from the divine difficult to understand. So I add a few features to my Angel Tarot decks to help make them easier to use. When I was initially learning the tarot as a young man, I'd taken a black marker and written the meaning on each card. As I learned, eventually I was able to replace that marked up deck with clean cards. Inspired by this, I decided to place phrases and guide words on each card so that my Angel Tarot decks could be used immediately out of the box without the need for study or research. I believe that Source and the angels are always trying to guide us towards joy. Since tarot is merely a language for speaking to the divine, every card in tarot is a message of love and is leading us to happiness. No matter what card you draw, it will always be love. It can't be anything other than love, because the divine only wants you to be happy, and tarot is the divine speaking to you. While we're speaking about the divine, or source, the universe, God, goddess, or whatever name you like, as you listen to this book, keep in mind that I consider all of these to be just different words for the all that is. If you use a different name, please just hear the word you most resonate with in your mind as you listen. My desire in creating Angel Tarot is to help you feel the love, compassion, and hope that tarot can bring into your life. I wanted to bring this centuries-old magical art out of the shadows and into the full view of divine light. Finally, it is my greatest desire that these cards will bring you immense blessings as you move along your spiritual path. I hope that you can now see tarot as it has always appeared to me, an angelic map leading the way to a joyous, magical life. Love, Radleigh. Part 1. The Basics of Angel Tarot. Chapter 1. Bright and Beautiful Guidance. Tarot is a language of the divine. It is one of the countless ways in which heaven lovingly speaks to us in order to guide us on the path to joy. However, for centuries, this beautiful divination tool has been shrouded in secrecy and fear. By creating the Angel Tarot cards and writing this book, it is my intention to remove any anxiety by fully revealing this beautiful oracle and putting any concerns to rest. Even Tarot's beginnings seem mysterious. People have been led to believe for hundreds of years that Tarot originated in ancient civilizations and was purposefully encoded with secrets that only a chosen few were meant to understand. This concept has often created distress for sensitive people, not to mention the lack of confidence so many experience when even approaching a tarot deck. Well, it's time to breathe a sigh of relief, because tarot was created for all of us. Its origins aren't in a dark chamber of an ancient secret society. No, it began as a creation of happiness, laughter, and togetherness. Actually, as a game meant for families to play. Now that may come as a surprise, but consider the energy that was placed into these cards from the very beginning. It was joy, creativity, and fun. And just like tarot, our lives are meant to be playful, a happy game that can bring us enlightenment and inspiration. As time went by, tarot was appreciated by millions of people who enjoyed the game that it was created to be, but who were also seeking insight and guidance. They began to see something in the cards, a story that mirrored their lives. So tarot started to evolve. People shared their cards and their divinatory qualities with their friends and handed down the knowledge to their children and grandchildren. Somewhere down the line, though, associations formed around tarot and other mystical arts that were perhaps created by well-meaning people. However, these individuals were most likely secretive types who enjoyed knowing things that others didn't. Sadly, their actions and possessive attitudes towards tarot made it seem intimidating, shadowy, and somewhat frightening. It was like taking a big blanket and throwing it over a very bright lantern. Well, guess what? We're now in the 21st century, and we in the angel community don't like secret knowledge, exclusive societies, or intimidation. So the blanket has been lifted, and the lantern is shining brighter than ever. Some ask what makes tarot work. Well, the answer to that question is simpler than one might think. Imagine people walking through an untamed forest. These explorers tell of their positive experiences to friends who then want to see them for themselves. Eventually, the path through the forest gets worn down. These are the trailblazers. Much like the people who first saw epiphanies hidden in a card game. And since that time, millions have followed that path. Through the power of their combined belief and faith in tarot, they created a direct form of communication with heaven. That's what tarot is. What makes tarot work is all of us collectively seeking answers through a beautiful, loving, divinatory tool. Most people use tarot to help others receive divine guidance. And these individuals are earth angels in service to humankind. So, as you can see, tarot is still doing exactly what it was originally created to do, make people happy. Chapter 2, The Beginnings of Angel Tarot. The history of tarot is fairly complex, with many twists and turns, according to historians. However, if we maintain a high-level overview, it can be explained rather easily. The origins of tarot. The earliest evidence of tarot cards that we can find takes us to the early 15th century in northern Italy. Ordinary playing cards pre-exist tarot, but the adding in of the...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.